Hey guys, so today we're going to be looking at the Power Rumble FX. Yes, play longer, louder, and livelier. This is for the Game Boy Advance, and this was created back in... 2001. That would make it 16 years old. This thing is 16 year old. This is older than a lot of people on the internet. So yeah, apparently this adds a really cool little feature to the Game Boy. It adds a little rumble feature, and not only that, it supplies power so you can play longer, and also has nice dual speakers. I'm very intrigued as to how this works out, so let's get this out of the packaging and take a look. Okay, so first on the back it says Power Rumble FX, the 3-in-1 enhancer for Game Boy Advance. Built-in rumble, dual stereo speakers, and a 20-hour battery to give a kick to your marathon gaming sessions. Rubber-tipped handle grips, available in purple and iceberg blue. And then comes in a variety of different, flavors. Well, as you can see, this is the ice-colored one. Pretty cool. Let's take a closer look. Have I ever mentioned how much I hate plastic? Right. Okay, we heft it open. Let's rearrange the camera now. Alright. Don't need that anymore. Alright, so what we get is we get the base unit itself, which is pretty cool. It's a built-in unit with the grips, as described, and also comes with inbuilt batteries. That's pretty cool. There's no way to get to them, though. Suppose we'd have to unscrew all this to check out these cells. Considering it's 16 years old, I am very dubious as to whether these cells actually even work. There's an on-off switch on the side with a nice little cable to go into the bottom of your Game Boy Advance to get the speakers. And here, you can set it to sound only, rumble on, phone. What the heck is phone? I'm guessing this is where you can plug earphones into it? Maybe? I'm guessing so. So yeah, that's pretty darn cool. So let's get this thing plugged in and find out what the hell's going on, because, 3 volts DC. Let's see if we can get this thing working, because guess what? The power adapter is, of course, a European one. Alright, it's been a few months since I've actually done the unboxing video of this Power Rumble FX. It's actually pretty darn good. One thing I can say about it is that it does live up to its 20-hour battery life. It could shy of about 16, which is, for something that came out in, 2001, 2003? I don't know. I've forgotten the year. It's been months and I don't even have the packaging anymore. But for something that boasted 20 hours... it lasts a long time. Unfortunately, it takes about 10 hours to become fully charged, and it doesn't tell you if it's fully charged, which is a bit of a bummer. One thing of note is that this power LED... isn't an indicator of battery level. It's just a full-on LED and will not dim until it dies, which I kind of hoped that it would, but it didn't, so when it cut off suddenly, I was like... God damn you. So, yeah, that was a bit of a shame, because Game Boy Advance obviously had the green light and it turns red when it's low, and every other Game Boy before that was a red LED until it's dead. And it just grew dimmer and dimmer and dimmer. And you're just like that. I remember looking at the Game Boy really close going, it's got some battery life. I need new batteries! But it's pretty darn cool. To put this on and take it off, it's pretty easy. It's got a nice little thing here, so you better make sure not to catch that while you're holding it, otherwise your Game Boy will fly out. So, yeah, it's got a little latch here. It's got the little power cell prongs there. Basically, they just go into the back of your Game Boy like that. You've got two hooks there that hook onto the bottom where it usually goes. So it's kind of a bit like a hinge. And then you just close it and it's secure. It's not going anywhere. There is a bit of a rattle, but it's not really of concern. It's not coming off. It's pretty secure. And once it's in your hand, well, it's not really going anywhere. And it still kind of fits in your pocket. It fits in my pockets anyway, because, I'm a big lad. So that's pretty darn cool. To connect it up, you just plug that into your headphone jack, and boom! It's all set up and ready to go. It is that simple. One thing of note is that the vibrate function is pretty naff. So this thing pretty much just serves as a power bank and grip, if you care. Although if you've got big hands like me, the grips are... I wouldn't say they're uncomfortable, but they're not ideal either. I kind of prefer it, the thinner form factor, but that's personal preference. If you've got smaller hands than me, which, I've got big man hands, you might be more comfortable with this, but It's pretty cheap now, so you can go pick it up anyway if you're curious. Plus, it's a power bank. That's pretty darn handy. It's much better than this little farty thing that I got from Game back in the day. Yeah, still have no idea what the hell I did with the plug. But, hey, maybe it works. DCN, DCN. Looks about the same. No, Dan, do not experiment. So, yeah, how else shall I show you this? Well, I had a couple of games arrive today. Let's see. Well, the first one was Pokemon Green, which is pretty darn cool. And Pokemon Pink. Yes, these are Chinese bootlegs that I bought for literally a couple of quid from China. I do not recommend them. But hey, they work, so don't class this as an advertisement, but eh. I mean, they're bootlegs, so your usage will literally vary because some of them will explode, while some, like mine, work. I'm lucky. So yes, we're going to play some Pokemon Green, which I believe is just pretty much just Pokemon Blue, but they changed the sprites. I don't know. But it's English, which is pretty darn cool. Now you'll notice there was no sound, and there still is no sound. Where's the sound? That's because I haven't turned it on. Ah, yes. You ready? Ah, yeah. So I don't know if you can hear the vibration, but it vibrates whenever they hit. It didn't vibrate then. Basically, the vibrate happens when there's a loud noise. It's completely volume-based. That is the only connection it has to the Game Boy, so it's obviously via volume. So let me just turn that down to make sure you guys can actually hear me. So yeah, this is Pokemon Green, apparently. The save actually works, which is pretty darn cool. I played it for a little bit beforehand just to make sure it actually works, which is very nice. All right. So to make sure the volume actually doesn't get in the way of you, I'm actually going to plug in some headphones that I've got on. There you go. So now, I really don't think you'll be able to hear it through the headphones. The headphones are right next to the camera, but I doubt you'll hear it. Alright, so hopefully I can show you the vibrate function, because the videos I've noticed on YouTube don't actually show the vibrate function, so I'm going to show that right now before I give more final thoughts on it. Okay, so as it is volume-based, it will happen at a completely random interval. And because this is a bootleg, it probably it works even less. I don't know. But it seems to happen whenever there's a loud noise. So basically, if I've got it set to a medium range, so the vibration shouldn't be that loud. In fact, I'll turn the vibrate to maximum so you can actually definitely hear it. All right. Now, it will either work or it won't, so we'll find out. Nope, it didn't vibrate. Oh, there's a little vibrate there. Yeah, because it's completely volume-based. Hold on, let me just turn it down in my ear. Alright. I love how it's like vibrating to the music. That's one thing you'll notice as well. So let me just turn that to volume again. Don't want it to vibrate during the music. So you have to literally adjust the knob when it comes to the vibrate. Alright, let's reduce the volume bit more. There you go. Let's see if we can adjust it. See? Vibrated when I attacked then, which is pretty darn cool. It also vibrates at random intervals, but the idea behind it is that it rumbles whenever you do something in the game. You're like jumping, shooting, something like that. So I've got it configured so that it vibrates whenever you attack and get attacked, which is pretty darn cool. Yeah, it vibrated a little bit when it went doo-doo-doo. But, it's making little vibrates to the music. That's adorable. But yeah, there's not really much to show. It's literally just the rumble, so I don't want to spend too long on it. Basically, you just get it, set it to the volume you want. It takes a lot of messing around within it. Probably, it's just a gimmick at the end of the day. It's the vibrate feature is literally just a gimmick. Yep, vibrated when I got attacked. That's cute. I love how there's a little glitch here. If you look here, there's a little glitch whenever I get attacked, which is kind of adorable. Yeah, it vibrates whenever I attack someone, which is pretty cool. I don't know if you noticed that, but there was a little glitch there. There's a little glitch in the system, which is pretty hilarious. But, yeah. Okay, let me just turn down the volume and pull that out. The stereo speakers themselves are actually pretty darn good. I don't know if you'll be able to tell the difference through this camera microphone, put the volume about there. So this is it from the Game Boy itself for its mono speaker. I don't know if this is stereo. I really don't think so, because it's one speaker. I guess it's classed as mono. As for the stereo speakers, though, yes, plug it into itself. Inception. That's actually good for storage. Right, ready? Oh, turn off the vibration feature. Yeah, if it goes too loud, you can hear it peaking. Yeah, that's really nasty peaking. So, if you reduce the volume, it actually sounds pretty good. It does sound pretty good, but at the end of the day, it's not really ideal. The best way to play it, in my opinion, is still with earphones. I will always recommend wearing earphones and headphones when playing on Game Boy, because that's when you get the best chiptune in your ears, which makes me very, very happy. It's still the best way to get it, and you still have that option with this, but you just get a power bank with it. So it's a really, really great power bank. So let's go have some final thoughts. Alrighty, guys, one of my final thoughts on the Power Rumble FX. It's a neat bit of kit. It's not the worst gimmicky thing. In fact, it's probably the best gimmick for the Game Boy I've ever seen. Besides the Game Boy Light, obviously, which is a necessity if you want to play any of the games at nighttime. You guys know that feel when you're going down, it's a complete tangent right now, when you go down the motorways and you by the street lamps, every time you went by a street lamp, you're like, do as much as you can. Right, wait till the next street lamp, and you just kept playing like that. That was fun times, right? But yes, this is probably the best gimmick that the Game Boy ever got. It's literally just a power bank. Every other feature it boasts is meh at best. The grips are far too small for me personally. If you've got smaller hands, it might be alright for you, but I've got big hands, it's not good at all. The rumble feature is a pretty neat gimmick. It's fun to play with and have whenever you fancy it, but thankfully it's completely optional with the switch of the bottom. I mostly play with it off and just use the speakers. As for the speakers are okay. They're pretty nice. They're stereo sound, so you've got that going for you, but they do have the problem of peaking when the volume's too high, so reduce that volume a bit. I still recommend using headphones or little earphones when you're playing your Game Boy out and about. But other than that, it's pretty neat, and the 20-hour battery life on this thing, pretty darn awesome, and because, well, this thing's ancient. It came out in, like, I don't know, 2001, 2002, 2003. I can't remember what year it was. I've slept since then. It's been a couple of months. As you can see, I look different. But it's pretty, pretty awesome. The battery is pretty intact. It's a lithium-ion battery. They tend to not die. They only die through prolonged usage and bad storage. But got pretty lucky with this. I've found this in the market for a couple of quid. Can't go wrong. So for a power bank, this thing is a must-have. It is a must-have. It's much better than the little mini battery packs you can get for the Game Boy Advance. However, then again, if you care about playing Game Boy games, you'd probably play it on the Game Boy Advance SP with the, the front lit screen? Back leg? I can't remember. I don't use it. I mostly emulate these days on my MAME arcade. I don't even know if you guys can see it. So yeah, let me know what you guys think of this power bank. It's literally just a power bank. It's the Power Rumble FX. The vibration feature, very gimmicky. The speakers, acceptable, but not very good. But other than that, if you can find it for a couple of quid, get it, because it's the best power bank you will get for the Game Boy Advance. So, let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care, survivors.